Dear students, previous classes will be detailed discussed about microbes in household products, microbes in industrial products, microbes in sewage treatment, microbes as a biogas in production, microbes as biocontrol agents. Today we are going to discuss about the last topic on here, microbes as biofertilizers. Microbes as biofertilizers. Microbes are useful, essential to life on earth. Microbes are very useful to, essential to life on earth. Microbes are useful in household purpose. Microbes are useful in industrial purpose. Microbes are useful in sewage treatment purpose. Microbes are useful in biogas production purpose. Microbes are useful in biocontrol agents. Microbes are useful in biofertilizers. These are the using in microbes to be human life on earth. Those microbes are here, especially fungi, bacteria and viruses. Okay, now fungi, bacteria and viruses. Some of the microbes are here, that is protozoa, bacteria, viruses, algae, fungi. But very important microbes are here, bacteria, virus and fungi. Okay, now dear students, today we are going to learn about biofertilizers. First of all, what is the meaning of biofertilizers? Okay, now biofertilizers are organisms. So these organisms, the enrich the nutrient quality of the soil. Biofertilizers are organisms. Those organisms are here, bacteria, cyanobacteria and fungi. These organisms are grown the soil and to be increasing of the nutrient food material, that is called biofertilizer. By means the soil is always fertility. Fertilizer means the soil is always fertility. Why? Because well-developed nutrient food material are developed. Okay, now so here biofertilizers are organisms. So these organisms, the enrich the nutrient quality of the soil. That is called biofertilizers. Okay, now dear students. So the main sources of the biofertilizers are in bacteria, cyanobacteria and fungi. Okay, now what are the biofertilizer organisms? Such as bacteria, cyanobacteria and fungi. These three organisms are to be used in biofertilizer process. Then after to be increasing of the nutrient quality for the soil. So hence soil is always fertility. Okay now. So these biofertilizers used in an organic farming. What is the use of biofertilizers? Okay now, dear students. Biofertilizers is always used in organic farming. Biofertilizers such as bacteria, cyanobacteria and fungi is always used to be organic farming. Okay, now discuss about one biofertilizer organism such as rhizobium bacteria, such as rhizobium bacteria. Okay, here this rhizobium bacteria is always closely associated with the legume plants of the roots. Legume plants of the roots. So these bacteria will be form of nodules. That is called the nodule roots. That is called the nodule roots or root nodules. Okay, now one biofertilizer organism such as rhizobium bacteria. The bacteria named are here rhizobium bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria is always closely associated within the legume plants of the roots. That is called symbiotic association. That is called symbiotic association to be form a root nodules or root nodules of the roots. Root nodules or nodules of the root. Okay, students, clearly understood. One of the biofertilizer organism such as rhizobium bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria is always closely associated with the legume plants of the roots. So this process is known as symbiotic association. So these rhizobium bacteria will be form a root nodules or nodules of the roots. Nodules of the roots. Okay, now nodules of the roots of leguminous plants are formed by symbiotic association of rhizobium bacteria. Rhizobium bacteria. What is the function of rhizobium bacteria? Rhizobium bacteria is always forming of the root nodules. So these root nodules containing to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen. So this to fix atmospheric nitrogen converted into organic forming. Converted into organic forming. Then after the plant to be utilized in their nutrient. The plant to be utilized in their nutrient. That is the importance of rhizobium bacteria. Biofertilizer organism, the best example one, rhizobium bacteria. This rhizobium bacteria is closely associated with the leguminous plants of the roots, such as groundnut, beans, such as groundnut and beans. So those leguminous plants of members to be containing root nodules, to be containing root nodules. In those of root nodules are having to fix atmospheric nitrogen. This fixed atmospheric nitrogen converted into organic forms. So this organic forms to be utilized in the plant to be nutrient. To be nutrient, that is the importance of rhizobium bacteria. Not only rhizobium bacteria and some of the free living bacteria are here. Free living bacteria are here. These free living bacteria are also fixing of the nitrogen. Fixing of the nitrogen, that is free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. Generally, rhizobium bacteria are grown in the soil and to be adapted to leguminous plants of the roots. Then after to be forming a root nodules. In those are root nodules containing fixed atmospheric nitrogen and converted into organic forming. This organic forming to be utilized of the plant in their nutrients. Okay, now and another bacteria are here such as Astrobacter and Azospirillum. Azospirillum and Astrobacter. So these bacteria are not closely associated with the another plants of the roots. Directly to be fixing of the nitrogen. Directly to be fixing of the atmospheric nitrogen. Both are free living bacteria. Both are free living bacteria. Okay, now Azospirillum and Astrobacter is always grown for the surrounding environment. So these bacteria is also to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen and then it will be converted into organic forms. So those named free living nitrogen fixing bacteria. Free living nitrogen fixing bacteria such as Astrobacter and Azospirillum. Astrobacter and Azospirillum. Okay, how? Okay, dear students, anyhow, rhizobium bacteria and Azospirillum. Astrobacter, both bacteria are to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen. Okay, now another biofertilizer organism such as fungal member. Another biofertilizer organism, that is fungal member. One fungal member named glomus. Glomus fungal member is always closely associated with the the roots of higher plants. Roots of the higher plants. Rhizobium bacteria is also closely associated with the leguminous plants of the roots. At the same time, the fungal member of glomus is always closely associated with the roots of higher plants. By means, is always closely associated with the higher plants of the roots. Higher plants of the roots. This symbiotic association is named mycorrhizal. This symbiotic association is named as mycorrhiza or mycorrhizal plant. Mycorrhizal plant. Okay, now one symbiotic association between the rhizobium bacteria and the leguminosary plants of the roots. Another symbiotic association with glomus fungal member and higher plants of the roots. And higher plants of the roots. Okay, here. So the fungal member of glomus is closely associated with the roots of higher plants. This symbiotic association is named as mycorrhiza or mycorrhizal plants. Mycorrhizal plants. What is the importance of mycorrhiza? So here, dear students, mycorrhiza is always absorbed for phosphorus from the soil. From the soil, then after to be passed into the plant. Then after passed into the plant. Okay now. So higher plants are not containing sufficient phosphorus. In those of time, one of the fungal member to be absorbed of the phosphorus from the soil, then after passed into the plant. Then after passed into the plant. This is the importance of mycorrhiza. Okay now, dear students, rhizobium bacteria is always to fix atmospheric nitrogen and into organic forms. But mycorrhiza is always absorption of phosphorus from the soil, then after passed it into the plant. That is the importance of mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza not only absorption of phosphorus, then also to be carrying up another functions. Those are beneficial functions, such as is always increasing resistance to root borne diseases. Increasing resistance to root borne diseases and tolerance to salinity and drought, and overall increasing of the plant growth and development. These are the another beneficial functions. These are the another beneficial functions. Okay now, dear students, mycorrhiza not only increasing of the phosphorus levels from the soil and also carrying another beneficial functions, such as resistant to root borne diseases, tolerance to salinity and drought, and increasing overall the plant growth and development. Plant growth and development. That is the importance of mycorrhiza. Okay now, another biofertilizer organism such as cyanobacteria. Such as cyanobacteria. So cyanobacteria is one of the anaerobic microbe. This is widely distributed in aquatic as well as terrestrial environment. Aquatic as well as terrestrial environment. This is also to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen. Then after converted to organic forms such as Nasta, Anabina and Acidatoria. Both are cyanobacteria. Both are cyanobacteria. Okay now, don't confuse are here. Normal bacteria are here. Rhizobium bacteria, Azospirillum and Acidobacter, both bacteria are to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen. And cyanobacteria are here, Nasta, Anabina, Acidatoria. Nasta, Anabina, Acidatoria, both are cyanobacteria. Generally, cyanobacteria are anaerobic, heterotrophic microbes, widely distributed in aquatic and terrestrial environment. As they mainly sources of fixed atmospheric nitrogen and convert into organic forms. Another importance of biofertilizer are in paddy fields such as cyanobacteria. Another importance of biofertilizers in paddy fields such as cyanobacteria this cyanobacteria is also to be growing up the soil by means also soil in the enrich of the nutrient quality or added organic matter. So hence the soil is always fertility. Hence the soil is always fertility. Okay, now dear students, another importance of biofertilizers as used in paddy fields such as cyanobacteria. This cyanobacteria is also add organic matter to the soil. So hence the soil is always fertility. Hence the soil is always fertility. That is the importance of cyanobacteria. So these are the biofertilizer organisms. Those biofertilizer organisms such as bacteria, glomus fungi, and cyanobacteria. The bacteria best example, Rhizobium bacteria, Azospirillum, and Acetobacter. Both are to be fixed atmospheric nitrogen and convert into organic forms. Next, glomus fungus is always absorption of phosphorus from the soil. Then after passed it into the plant. And cyanobacteria is always important to paddy fields. So is also they add the organic matter. So hence is always soil is always fertility. So increasing of the fertility to be utilized by cyanobacteria such as Nostoc, Anabina, and Acetoria. Nostoc, Anabina, and Acetoria. Okay, now next we are going to discuss about challenges posed by microbes. Challenges posed by microbes. Okay, now dear students. So if the microbes are well resistant to drugs, if the microbes become well resistant to drugs, these microbes are known as super microbes. These microbes are known as super microbes. Okay, now Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria, that is BT, is always resistant to insects and pests. Insects and pests. So those cropping plants, BT cotton, BT brinjal, BT tomato, BT potato, BT soybean, and also some of the antibiotics such as chloromycin, tetracycline, erythromycin, chloramphenicol. These are also increasing of the resistance power. Okay, now if the microbes become is always resistant to drugs, if the microbes become is always resistant to drugs, these microbes are named as super microbes. Super microbes. Okay, now dear students, so here eggs, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, Mantoux diseases, and severe acute respiratory syndromes such as SARS. These are the commonly emerged diseases. These are the recently commonly emerged diseases. So AIDS is caused by one type of virus. Mantoux diseases is caused by one type of prions. So severe acute respiratory syndrome is caused by one type of virus. So both all are emerged diseases. Both all are emerged diseases. Not to be suddenly death. Not to be suddenly death. So to be increasing of the lifespan several years. To be increasing of the lifespan in several years. Okay, now AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, is caused by HIV virus. Mantoux disease is caused by prions, one type of virus. Severe acute respiratory syndrome, SARS, is caused by one type of virus. So these are the identified recently emerged diseases. Recently emerged diseases. Another diseases are here cholera, tuberculosis, and dengue fever. These are the re-emerging diseases. Not harmful. To be prevent in those of diseases, to be increasing of the certain lifespans. So mainly depend upon to the resistance power. Okay, now cholera, tuberculosis, and dengue fever. These are the re-emerging diseases. Okay, now. So another importance are here bioterrorism. Bioterrorism is involves so the actual use of or the threat of the biological agents in order to spread fear and infective diseases and death in our population that is called bioterrorism. Bioterrorism is one of the term refers to the actual use of or the threat use of biological agents in order to so severe to fear and diseases and death made upon the populations, death made upon our population, that is called bioterrorism. How to controlling of bioterrorism? So nowadays we developed well developed technology, so that is named advancing genomics and bioinformatics can produce rapid detection method. So in those are bioterrorisms. So that is the importance of bioterrorism. So here this is about microbes as biofertilizers and the challenges posed by microbes. Okay, now thank you.